Get ready, here we go. Our feature bout this week is going to be Virgil squaring off against Rick the Model Martel. Let's join that matchup, our feature this week, in progress.
If he asked to go to England and they took a vote on it, they'd say yes, because the English public really like him.
Well, remember the response he got in Sheffield, Alfred?
Yes, I do indeed.
Boy, they really loved him there.
They certainly
do. Of course, they don't know the guy very well. But, he's a nice guy. Really a nice guy.
Yes, he is. But at the same time, I only judge a man's ability by what he does inside the ring, not by necessarily his personal presence. And I think, oh, gosh. Oh, did he make Martel look a little bit humble there? Oh, golly.
Little Muhammad Ali shuffle there.
Oh, look at Martel.
And he's embarrassed.
Oh, he is indeed. He's smarting under that. Oh, golly. That's the way you can hurt Martel. His pride is severely dented.
Now, further humiliating him by doing some of Martel's things that he loves to do so much. Arm ringer being exchanged back and forth here. Who's going to end up with control? It's not the mob. Nice arm drag by Virgil.
Superb timing by Virgil. Really good stuff here. He certainly is the most improved wrestler of the 90s.
Got some nice-looking tights, too, Alfred.
Got some nice-looking girlfriends as well.
I don't remember ever seeing you in anything like that, Alfred.
No. I never wore those.
I don't think so. Boy, there have been so many innovations. Oh, backslide coming up! Almost successful, and right back to that arm drag. Have you seen the trunks being worn by High Energy? Coco Beware and the Rocket?
Well, I've seen the ones that Coco Beware wears. They come up to his neck. He can put a tie around those.
Oh, boy. Things have really changed, Your Lordship.
They certainly have. Gosh, I couldn't see you in a pair of those either, Gorilla, in your heyday.
I've got some on order. Oh, look at that. Put his head down. Cardinal mistake made by Virgil. What a day it will be at Wembley Stadium. I just can't fathom standing there and looking at 80,000 plus people.
And to sort of encompass in your mind that the staff, the booking office, did that, booked that whole stadium in just 10 hours. How could they do that so well?
A lot of that, I understand, done by phone orders, you know.
Oh, yes, I don't see anywhere else they could do that.
Oh, look at that nice suplex, gut-wrench style done by the model. Hooks the leg, but you won't get Virgil that way. Got to have Virgil in a little more compromised position than that. Is there going to be some kind of a prize for this tug-of-war, Your Lordship?
Well, I would imagine one or two of them will be, or both of them, or maybe neither, will be very satisfied by winning this particular challenge. But I must go along with Mr. Perfect. If you select a team of wrestlers, the huge, powerful men that we have in wrestling today, I'm sure they could beat anybody.
Yeah, but the guys that you're speaking of, Alfred, are not friends of Mr. Perfect. Perfect's going to end up with guys on his team that are his friends. You can count them on one hand.
You mean to say that somebody, no matter how big and powerful, take, for example, Earthquake.
Now, wouldn't for one moment have anything to do with Mr. Perfect.
You don't think he'd be the anchor man?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
Well, I think he would. I think Mr. Perfect is,
I'll tell you one guy for sure. I don't know this for a fact, but I would assume that the Tricky Rick would definitely be a team member. Look at that. Stooping to that low. You know something? He got so upset in this match that he lost it, Alfred. Lost it. Let's go up and get the official word of what went down here.
Here is your winner as a result of a disqualification. Virgil!
Look at the look on his face, Alfred.
Well, I think that all went to earlier in this match when Virgil made such a mockery of the skills of the model, and he was burnt, he was hurt by that, and at last he got his revenge. A very lucky winner, but a winner nevertheless, Virgil.